We love cats, and no matter how old they get, we'll always treat them like our little kittens. But today, I'm gonna talk about a kitten that, by the tragedy of fate, was immortalized as a three-week-old cub for 35,000 years. I'm Reisuka, the cosplaying paleontologist, and today I'm going to be telling you all about one of the most important paleontological mummies ever found, the Homotherium cub. My channel is the only one where you can learn about all of the latest dinosaur science and news from a real paleontologist, so be sure to like and subscribe for more. Now, what looks like a sleeping kitten here is actually a corpse that's been perfectly preserved in ice for a very long time. This could only happen because this cub died in the permafrost of Siberia. And since this place is always covered in ice, it died in the perfect conditions to become a natural mummy. No, not a natural mommy, silly. That's me, not the cub. So like that dino nugget pack you forgot in the freezer, this made it almost impossible for decomposing bacteria to be able to live near the mummy and break it down. And that's what a natural mummy is. A corpse that's preserved almost exactly how it was in life because the animal happened to die in the perfect mummification conditions. And the rarity of this occurrence is the reason why paleontologists cheer when we find a new mummy. Besides being rare, it can provide answers that can't be provided by just looking at the fossils of extinct animals. And by analyzing this cub, we could learn things about saber-toothed tigers that we never would have known otherwise. First off, where it was found was not where paleontologists would have expected to find a Homotherium in the late Pleistocene. While they arose in Eurasia around 4 million years ago in the early Pleistocene, with the latest fossils in the region mostly being around 300,000 to 200,000 years old. This cub is much more recent at 35,000 years old. But let's take a step back before talking more about this mummy. What even is a Homotherium? They're a species of saber-toothed tiger that lived in a wide range of places. Homotherium fossils have been found in the Americas, Europe, and Africa, with the most productive fossil sites being in North America. While it does look like a modern cat, this is not a cat or a tiger, but it's still a feline. Modern cats belong to the Felinae subfamily, while Homotherium belongs to the Macarodontinae family. On a side note, saber-toothed tiger might not really be a correct scientific term, depending on who is being classified as one. If you're using it to talk about the Macarodontinae, yeah, it's a valid term, and a valid subfamily because this group shares a common ancestor. But sometimes Thylacosmilus is thrown in the mix, and they do not share a common ancestor with other saber-tooths because they are a marsupial and not a feline, and therefore it would make saber-tooth an invalid biological group. But whether saber-tooth is a valid classification or not, this cub can teach us a lot about how these animals developed those famous, powerful front teeth from a young age. The cub had a very muscular neck and front limbs, and this shows how adapted these animals were to pinning prey down and piercing them with their giant teeth. Because this cub died at only 3 weeks old, it doesn't have its signature teeth yet. However, we can see that its upper lip was about twice the size of that of a baby lion at the same age, and that these giant teeth may have been exposed in other saber-toothed tigers. Or maybe these cats just like to be different, because this cub is also rocking a very unique goatee. Paleontologists aren't sure if it's something that all members of Macarodontinae have, or if it's something that's exclusive to Homotherium. That's something that we need more mummies to actually figure out. But something we can know right now is that this little kitten had toe beans. They're more rounded than those of modern cats, which would have made it easier for them to walk on snow and made them less susceptible to frostbite. It's sad that this cub had such a premature fate, but it will live on forever in our hearts, just like our cats will forever be our little kittens. And just like I'll forever be your mommy. Make sure to like and subscribe so you don't miss any of the latest paleontology, science, and news.